Imagine you're a tree in a forest. Maybe you were planted first, or others around you were unalived. Either way, you are the oldest one there, and therefore probably the tallest. Okay, now come back to reality. You are short again. And no, you're not a short king either. You're a short civilian. A tax-paying, God-fearing, booger-picking, booger-eating civilian. Anyways, these tall old trees are called hub trees. They make more sugar than they need. And since they're big, they're easy targets.
Unlike us short civilians.
Huh? Who said that? Now, look at the forest floor. You'll see these funny little guys. They're so funny that we call them fungi. These fungi need sugar to survive.
I need sugar!
But bro can't even perform photosynthesis.
I can't do it!
So they grow into hub trees. And when I say grow in, I mean grow into the bark and steal resources.
I'm gonna put this here. Hey, where'd it go? I don't know, I didn't take it. I think there is a fungus among us.
This type of fungus is called mycorrhizal fungus. Now, why wouldn't the tree just make some chemicals and get rid of the fungus?
Get out of here. Go on, get. Go. It's not okay to be here. This is your last warning. I called the forest rangers and they'll be here soon.
But the fungus is actually helpful to the tree. You see, the roots of a tree only go down so deep, and they need oxygen, so they have to be close to the surface. But a fungus's root, called mycelium, can grow several meters deep, helping access more minerals in groundwater. And it's really thin, so it can adapt to changing nutrients in the ground. And the tree gives it sugar in return. So the tree's roots become basically obsolete and just give support.
So I can stay and give you resources, or I can stay and steal your resources.
Can stay you, but don't like it, I don't. And when if you can't give me resources, you don't, I cut you will off.
What?
Then the fungus spreads to other parts of the forest and finds other tree roots. It connects and trades resources with these new trees as well. Using these tree networks, different species of trees can send resources to each other. They can even send signals when there are diseases, insects, or grazing animals. It's like the internet, called the World Wide Web.
Let's check what's on today.
Suzanne
Simard has done some research about this. She put bags on trees and gave one of them radioactive gases. Yeah, this is the least insane scientist. And an hour later, she checked the other tree and it also had radioactive gases present. This proves that they send resources to each other. She also discovered that hub trees will send resources to young up-and-coming trees and send even more resources if the baby tree is the same species as itself. Hey guys, it's me, Mr. Treest, and today I'm gonna be giving away 1 million sugar to this tree.
Wait, me?
Congratulations! What are you gonna do with all this sugar?
I don't know. I'll probably send most of it to the fungus network for others to use.
Cut. Okay, you have to give me something more interesting.
Okay, I'm gonna go 10 miles taller.
Now, all of this was from a fungus UPS system as the middleman. But there's some trees that just shoot up a root and start growing a new tree there, like the aspen. One of them is called Pando, located in Utah, which seems like 47,000 different trees, but it's actually one big entity.
Okay, time to cut this tree. Huh? What? How's it doing that?
I am an aspen.
Okay, and this is a normal pen.
No, I mean we're all connected and can share resources. I am Groot.
Oh!
And that's how trees talk.